Hello YouTube people, let's talk about this calculator watch. I gonna be honest with you, I don't even know why I bought it. I watch too much YouTube, probably. I have seen a lot of reviews of this watch and everybody is so happy and so hyped about these calculator watches. And I saw one on Amazon with a discount and I wanted to try it out, so I bought it. And well, I know the problem is I don't really feel the connection with this watch. I usually buy watches that I want very much, so that's why most of my reviews are coming out very positive and they are very fun to watch. But with this watch, I just don't get the connection and honestly, I don't even know what to say. I'm not gonna tell you a history lesson about horological importance of this watch because 100 years ago something has happened and so on. I personally just don't care about those things. And the problem with this watch is, in my case, it's because I am probably too old for this watch to be this very fashionable person. I would say this watch is for young, very fashionable people. And I myself don't really feel that young anymore. Maybe that's the problem. Another thing, I'm not old enough for this watch. I don't feel any kind of nostalgia for this watch because when I was a kid, this watch was already kind of old thing, so it doesn't relate to me at all. So with that out of the way, let's talk about the watch. It has several negatives, technical negatives, I would say. First of all, it's very obvious, it doesn't have backlight. It has negative LCD, which in some lighting situations is pretty difficult to read, and yet it doesn't have light, so I would say it's a negative point. Another negative thing is that this rubber strap and the case, they do not match up in color. This rubber strap is like very dark brown mixed with red, and the case is like very dark red mixed with brown, and in real I can really easily tell the difference between the tone of the color, and it looks bad. It looks very bad, honestly. But that's all the negatives, I would say. I don't really see many more negatives. It's a very simple watch. So let's talk about the specs of this watch. So by my measurements, the size of this watch is 34.3 millimeters and lug-to-lug distance is 43 millimeters. The thickness where is the screen is 7.9 millimeters. So it's pretty small watch. It sits very nicely on the hand and it is also very light, very slim. You can't forget that you wear a watch on your hand. So about the functions of this watch. Well, yes, it has calculator, of course, but about other things. Very quirky feature that you can go to the calculator mode, press that little recess button and it mutes the buttons, it turns off the sound for the buttons. But if you go to the stopwatch function, even though that you have muted the buttons, it still beeps when you press the buttons in the stopwatch mode. So that mute function kinda loses the point for me. Another thing, this watch has dual time zone, which is very convenient for a lot of people. And how are these buttons, for example, if you wanna use stopwatch? Is it easy to use? Yes, using stopwatch on this watch is very easy because stop, start and reset buttons are placed on the bottom left corner and on the bottom right corner. So it's very easy to press just the corner. Let's move on to another topic, which is about the straps. Because this watch has 20 millimeter lugs, the space is pretty small where you can fit the strap. So I managed to squeeze in only these cheap NATO straps, which are very thin, and it looks very fun. It just comes alive on these NATO straps. Well, the first one, the black one, I like this the best. I think this watch with the black face looks the best on the black NATO strap. Next one is black, gray, red, and nah, I think this red stripe doesn't really work with this red case because it doesn't match up really well. It doesn't look that good, at least to me. And And this military green, it plays out very nicely with this color of the case. It has the same tone, I would say, and it matches up with this case very nicely. Looks really good on this military green NATO strap. And this classy NATO strap, it works with any watch, and this one is no exception. It looks pretty good. Not so bad, not bad at all. And this one for very fashionable people, black and white. It really asks for attention, this one. Looks interesting, yeah, looks interesting. So what are the conclusions? Well, I would say this watch is basically a fashion watch. The main point of this watch is to be fashionable, good-looking, interesting. But the main flaw of this watch is that the rubber strap tone of color doesn't match up with the case. And like, what's the point of being a fashion watch if you can't match the colors? It's ridiculous. Unless you're gonna put it on some kind of NATO straps, then yeah, it becomes very playful, comes alive. And it's a lot of fun, this watch. I can't see the point. If you are into this kind of style, you're gonna have a lot of fun. But if you are not going to change the strap, no, just don't buy it. The color tone doesn't match up. It looks ridiculous. It doesn't look good at all. Seriously, this rubber strap is just... I don't understand, Casio. Why? What? How can you put things like this into production? It's just... I don't understand. So, and don't forget one thing. This screen sometimes is difficult to read, and this watch doesn't have a backlight. So if you are alright with all these things, yeah, it's pretty fun watch, pretty fun. Not a strong recommendation. I just would say it could be fun for some people, that's all. So, thank you for watching. Have a nice day. Goodbye.